What is going on, everybody? Right now, I'm going to show you about 5 tricks to guerrilla marketing.
Jill, when they thought it was over.
Renegade.
We shot the world. And I brought a few of my partners with me this time.
What's going on, everybody? 5 guerrilla marketing tactics that work. First is door knocking, okay? This could be anything from knocking doors all day until you get a job, which pays very well. Make sure that it's legal where you're doing it, because a lot of areas it's not, because some people have ruined it. Or door knocking could be while you're doing a job, you let the people outside know that you work in the area. You want to have a good card, give them something to look at while you're talking to them. Once you get them talking, let them talk about what needs to be done. Do not interrupt. Don't point out things, because you may insult some people. What you want to do is let them know that you're listening, that you care. If you can, I always have a little notebook in my wallet that I take out and I write things down that they're talking about. You know, oh, I have problems with, you know, my hedges. It's that I can't keep up with them. My shoulders ain't what they used to be. My back is bad. I don't have the time, yada yada. Listen to them. Let them know that you're attentive, that you care about what they're telling you. Because if you do this, and you say, okay, so we do shrubs, we do lawns, we do seal coating, we do tree pruning, we do pressure washing, you can let them know that you are listening and that you can complete a job, and let them know that you're ready to do it, right? Okay, second one. And this one is one of the best, if you do it right. Because I've never really had great luck with door hangers just by, like, going out one day and peppering the neighborhoods. Because you're giving them a picture, you're letting them know, oh, okay, there's a business in the area, yada yada. 9 times out of 10, if you don't have something that pops out to them, like 10% off if you get your lawn mowed, or you know, refer a friend and get a free lawn mowing. And, you know, sometimes it's good to give things away. You know, some people say, oh, I don't like to work for free. You're not working for free if somebody refers you to somebody else. Because you don't sit there and say, oh, yeah, well, I'll mow your lawn, trim your hedges, do this, do that, do this, do that. And then you're racking up a $600-$700 bill. Specify what you'll give for free. And if they refer you, well, now you got 2 customers, okay? Especially if you're trying to work on route density, this works great. Route density is when, you know, you're not going to deliver newspapers to 30 different places in a whole city, right? You want to have 30 houses on one block. That way, whatever you're doing in the area, you're getting the most money in the shortest amount of time. So if you do this, and you do it right, door knockers can work good. So what you do is, you take it, after you get done a job, you take your door knockers, you go to each neighbor on each side, and then across the street, you hit 1, 2, 3, right in front of that job, okay? If anybody answers that door, and they say, oh, hey, what are you doing? Oh, no, I was just giving you this door knocker, we just wrapped up this job across the street. Now you're giving them something visually to look at. They know that you've been out there, but now you're giving them something like, oh, wow, look at that. That looks good. They do a good job. Well, how much would you charge me to do mine? Bam. That most of the time when I've worked neighborhoods, that's how I've gotten jobs. Hand over fist. Bop, 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 bop. They call it keeping it up with the Joneses, right? Everybody wants their yard to look better or as good as their neighbors. Because then, you know, they're going to drive up and say, you know, Bob's yard's looking real good, and mine's looking like trash. I may have to call those guys. But it's true. A lot of people, that every time you're doing them, you know, roundabouts, I call them, you know, they're already looking at you. They already see what you're doing. They kind of want to talk to you, but they don't know how to come at you, because sometimes when you're working, you can look, you know, frustrated or grumpy, and seem kind of standoffish. A lot of people don't like that, and it makes them kind of nervous, especially when we're doing outside yard work. It's a little bit easier sometimes if you're sort of dressed for the part. If you're, you know, in a nice suit and you're going door to door selling vacuum cleaners or insurance, or, you know, if you're, you know, you always want to actually, that's another thing too, okay? And I know I said only five strategies, but I'm going to throw this one in as a freebie. One thing that works really well, okay, and you can get shirts printed up very cheap. There's a lot of websites. I'm not going to make any money off of them. I'm not saying that's my sole purpose, but there's a lot of sites that will do shirts for cheap, okay? Now, Custom Ink happens to be one that I use all the time. And you can actually go into their, you can go into their menu and you can see no minimum, okay? Which means if you got two guys that work for you, you can get two shirts and, you know, you only pay 20, 30 bucks, okay? Or you can get 10 shirts and pay 325 bucks, which is a good deal. And you can make your own. When you're always, when you always got to remember, okay, when you're making a business, okay, this goes with guerrilla marketing. I'm not trailing off. When you're starting a business, okay, you always want to make sure that everything you do is eye-catching. Because 90% of people wanting you is how you sell yourself, how you present yourself. So if you're riding around and you're in a dirty shirt, dirty jeans, busted truck, they know you're a worker. That is not anything to be ashamed of, that you're dirty and you work hard and you may not have a beautiful truck. But I will tell you, and this is a matter of fact, if you have a nice truck, if you keep your truck clean, if you have uniforms, your guys are in uniforms, it will help sell you, because you are presenting upkeep. You're presenting clean. You're making yourself, that they're going to look at you and say, wow, you know, this guy, his whole crew's clean, his trucks are clean, his equipment is kept well, and they do a great job. You're selling yourself by how good you look, because nobody ever said, oh man, look at them. They look like they're going to rob my house. I should hire them. No. So, number three, okay? And this one goes hand in hand with the door knockers, okay? Is yard signs. Yard signs, yard signs, yard signs, okay? When you get going, yard signs can be your best friend, okay? Because when you have your door knocker and you have a yard sign, basically what's going to happen is you're going to show people, okay, one, that you're not scared to invest in yourself, okay? Two, it's going to tell them exactly who did the job, and they're going to be able to tell what's different. Nobody doesn't look at their neighbor's yard. Again, keeping up with the Joneses. People see it and they say, wow, look at this. This guy's yard now looks better than mine. I wonder who did it. So they may not necessarily look it right towards you, but if you keep coming back and they see you, they're going to say, yeah, these are the guys. They make his yard look great or her yard look great, and they're always here. I might as well holler at them one day. And it's happened to me. One time I've gone into a cul-de-sac and I landed 16 accounts. 16 accounts. And it literally went from six people to two people down the road to, hey, head over to my uncle's house, or hey, my brother lives over here. Do you guys work that area? Yeah, we do. Work every area, right? Until you start getting clientele, and then you want route density, because that's what's going to help you make your money, okay? But yard signs. You are, again, this is kind of like with the door knocking. You want to make sure that it's legal where you live. And sometimes you can get permits for the little 12x12s, but anything bigger than that. And this is key, because they will just grab all your signs and throw them right in the dump. Now, there's a website which is called UZ Marketing, and them, they will give you 100 yard signs and give you stands for 180 bucks. And that's not bad at all. That's $1.80 a piece with the metal stands. So you can pepper them, and even if you do lose 10 of them, that's only 18 bucks. And you still got another 82 of them. So you're not really losing out. And everything gets your name out there, okay? And signs, they help when you're doing the door knockers, right? You do the houses around them. You put a sign on their front yard as long as they're okay with it. Sometimes you say, hey, I'll take $5 off this job if you let me keep the sign here in a week. But don't throw it away. Keep it in your garage or somewhere, and I'll come pick it up in the week. But I'll take $5 off if you don't mind advertising for me. Most of the time, anybody's willing to make an extra buck or get a deal. So this will always work, no matter what it is, okay? Even if you say, hey, I'll mow your yard next week for free if you let me put my sign out here for you for 2 weeks, okay? Even still, that, oh, great, okay, I saved 30 to 55 bucks. Why not? And you're getting a marketing, guerrilla marketing. This is unconventional style, but it's the old school. It's what works. It's what has helped companies grow for decades, right? Okay. So now, the third one, and this works, but you want to make sure that you do certain things with it, okay? Is flyers, okay? Flyers do work, okay? But what you want to do is you want to make sure that, like with the door knockers, you're only passing them out to neighbors. So you have people that are walking by, they're walking their dog, or they're taking a power walk, or they're walking their kids, or checking their mail, whatever it is. Flyers are cheap and conventional, where you can actually say, you know, Mr. Property Service, now offering, and then you pepper all of your skills and what you do, okay, all your services, and then say, present this flyer at your free estimate and receive 10% off or 5% off. A lot of companies will offer 10% to guys who sell for them because it gets them in the door. It gets them that money and they make a client, okay? So if you give away 10% just for you handing out a flyer, you don't really lose anything because it's the same thing you would do if one of your workers was to make a referral or to get a job for you. So you don't really lose, ever. And with flyers, they're so cheap. I think you can get, it's like a penny a copy or 3 cents a copy. So you can get 1,000 of them for like 30 bucks, something like that. Pretty cheap anyway. Where was I going? I don't want to lose myself. Okay, yeah. So with the flyers, you're selling yourself, so you want to make sure that your flyers look really good, okay? You don't want something that's going to make people think like, oh, yeah, he put a lot of work into this, and it looks like crap, because nobody's going to call you back. Sometimes you got to dig deep and find somebody who can design things for you, you know, somebody who's good with a computer, or somebody who's good at making, you know, certain things, so that way, you get the most for your buck. You want something to look nice. You, like I said, you're selling yourself when you're starting your business. You have to make yourself appear like you are, that you have your stuff together, that you're clean, that you're going to get the job done right, and that you care about your appearance. Because if you care about your appearance, then you care about how somebody's job is going to come out and look, which is the most important thing. And, you know, this doesn't go with guerrilla marketing, but it's just kind of common sense. When you do get these jobs, always make sure that you pick up after yourselves. This goes hand in hand with marketing, okay? Is you have to make sure that when you leave a job, everything's picked up, all your tools are taken with you, any materials that you brought, you throw them away. Don't ask them if they have a trash can. Don't ask them if you can throw it away in theirs. It will make people very angry. Trust me. It's not so much that they care that you're throwing stuff away at their house, but they're paying you to do a service. They do not want to pay for your waste management and your cleanup as well. Okay? And then last but not least, and this kind of is one of the, again, most important, is word of mouth, okay? Offer referral system, which could be, hey, if you refer your friend, I'll do your yard for free. Another form of referral system is, hey, listen, I'm going to give you this flyer, okay? and make one up with coupons on it, okay? So it says 10% off of their job, okay? So if they didn't get one from you, because it could be their aunt, could be a friend, could be somebody they know that needs help around their yard, an older person, that says 10% off when presenting this coupon or flyer, okay? And then say, hey, if anybody calls me with this, let them know to write your name on the back of the coupon. That way, you can kind of present back to them and say, hey, thanks for getting me that job. I owe you a free lawn mowing, or I will give you a free hedge trimming, right? Or whatever it is, whatever your niche is, offer the gimmies, offer the rebates, and people always want a deal. So if you're that guy that will throw them a deal, as long as it doesn't break your pocket or mess kind of like what's going on with you, then it's well worth it, no matter what it is, okay? Another form of word of mouth, you know, is if you're the guy who does a great job for people, they want to tell their friends about you. This is kind of like a culmination of all four of what I just mentioned, okay? You know, you doing a job for somebody, it's not just about making your money and getting out of Dodge. It's not. You know, you always want to treat somebody like you would treat your grandmother, or your aunt, or your mom, or something, you know, a loved one. You want to make sure that you're putting love, care, that you know, that you're giving them their money's worth, that they know that they didn't just get railroaded by somebody who's a fly-by-night. You want to let people know that you're there to make sure that they get exactly what they need. Because if you're not that guy, they're going to find somebody else who can do it. And most of the time, that guy may be a little bit cheaper because he's fighting for the top as well. So, word of mouth, referral system, okay? And this is kind of a bonus one, actually, which works pretty good, okay? But Facebook has a marketplace, obviously. Everybody knows that. This isn't something new. But Facebook marketplace, Craigslist, places like this, people think are dead. They're not dead. A lot of older people, a lot of people who aren't, you know, trying to go on the talking phone book or in the yellow pages because nobody has a house phone no more. You know, or, you know, a lot of people who may go to Google, but they want somebody who's a little bit cheaper. And this is totally true, okay? Now, I'm doing a shout out to Keith Kalpas because he's said this before, is that when you're first starting, okay, you are the guy who's going to do more for less, and it kind of attracts people towards you. So you will get a lot of customers, and later on down the road, you can weed them out. You know, but he said it perfectly, is that, you know, okay, I did a lot of work for people who I would have broken my back for, and then when I upped my prices, they let me go. And that's just kind of how business works. And, you know, Keith Galf is a smart dude. Check out his channel. This is actually one of the reasons why I started my channel. Between him, Brian's Lawn Care, and Vending Nation, because I also do vending machines as well. But a lot of things that are going to hurt your feelings are about business, which is for other video. I don't want to trail off from the guerrilla marketing. But it's true. You know, you want to offer a good price that's going to make you money, get you paid, get in the door. Then you can kind of upsell yourself with different services to make that money sort of back. I'm not saying give away jobs unless there's a referral. If you throw somebody a lawn and say, hey, I'll mow your lawn, you get me this guy. Yeah, of course, you want to do things like that, because if you don't, you know, you have to be the bargain guy sometimes. You have to offer people a deal. So this is 5 marketing strategies. If you liked my video, please like, share, subscribe, hit the little bell, and make sure you catch my extra content. See you later, everybody.